This is the hair dye era, isn't it? I don't know. Did you use yourself?
The problem with this haircut, and this is the thing, when I first got that, when I first got that hair, I was like, it was different. It was new. It was like, I felt like we'd done something really cool. And it wasn't as extreme in the beginning. And I remember being in Southend, and there was a table of mums having Sunday brunch.
Oh, no.
And they all have my hair.
Right, we're going to play a game right now with Busted called Year 2000.
Okay.
Instead of three, you see what I...
Love it.
Yeah. And we want to know, you want to look at these pictures. These are pictures of you guys from 20 years ago in the year 2000-ish, let's say. 2003. But anyway, it's fine. And we want to know if they're pretty fine or pretty of the time.
Love it.
First one up. You guys, Matt, you are wearing some sort of netted.
It's a fishnet top.
It's a fishnet top.
It's I still have this shirt.
I do.
I saved it from this photo shoot. That jacket was a well worn piece for you, Charlie, wasn't it?
I mean, I would probably wear that now.
Yeah,
that is it. Nice. Yeah, I feel like that.
A jacket, T-shirt, I always kind of liked, so I have no issue with that.
Yeah, pretty fine.
Yeah,
pretty fine. Are you thinking,
I'd say pretty fine.
As a group,
JB's got a cool T-shirt. Yeah. You know what? I think that kind of works for
pretty
us.
Pretty fine. Yeah. We're going pretty fine.
Let's
for the
go
first
pretty
one.
Fine.
Lovely. Do you know what I noticed about you guys? A lot of hair.
Yeah.
A lot of hair.
There was a lot of peroxide in our camp, wasn't there?
Still is. Thankfully, we're still hanging on to it somehow.
There was a lot of bits, well, I want to say bits clipped in, but were we just saying bits that were like dyed
on
the sides?
They're all just dyed, yeah.
Just,
I mean, no clip-ins.
Absolutely nothing natural about Matt's hair.
Okay,
You went M&M for
that's
it, didn't you?
Fine.
Okay.
That's pretty fine.
So, this is your M&M era. Is that what we're saying, Matt?
I mean, this is M&M acne era.
Oh, do you know what? Boys growing up in the public eye. This is way... You guys are babies.
I mean, there's a lot of photos of me just looking really terrible.
look like you're...
I don't know where this is. Because
a young lad.
That's pre-launch.
This is the pre-launch of the Brits.
2003.
Yeah.
Charlie, this is standard jacket, blazer and tie.
Yeah,
loose tie. Because
you're not
in the office now.
Yeah, and also the jacket looks too big, so that's not looking good.
I'd wear that hoodie now.
Oh,
It's a little bit Ross Geller, isn't it, Charlie?
Yeah, I am. That is a bit Ross Geller.
It's a bit Ross Geller, yeah.
It's not a bad look.
No, just, it's not...
Okay.
Well,
I mean, overall, James is the only one happy with this.
I like that one of me better than the last one.
I mean, I'm wearing, I'm not unhappy with.
Oh yeah, Matt looks kind of cool.
I mean,
wearing,
my hair is all right.
A knitted jumper.
It's a bit Gareth Gates, my hair, isn't it?
it's
a bit of blonde Gareth Gates.
Yeah.
But I'm working it.
Okay, yeah. Pretty of the time.
I'd say pretty of the time.
But James is going pretty fine.
James, you look so young, mate.
Is it weird looking at these pictures?
I could be forgiven for being a school student.
Yeah. You do. Drunk. You could be 12, though. You do look about 12. How old? Hang on, you would have been
18.
Yeah.
Yeah, we all look very glassy-eyed as well.
Yeah, I think
it's been a heavy week.
I think there might have been a party.
I think there might have been a free bar possibly before you went.
I think so.
Right. Next
number
one.
Number three. Oh, hello.
Now I feel
I know where this is.
Where is it?
This is outside Band Aid 20.
Oh. Yeah.
I have a story about this.
Go on.
This was what I'm wearing here. I'm wearing a scarf, like a red scarf. And my now wife, that was the first present she ever bought me, was that scarf.
Oh.
And I lost it that day.
Oh, right.
Yeah, I had it the day before, and I lost it that day.
But it got its moment.
Got its moment, exactly. There it is in history.
You can show her. You can say.
Yeah. It's also really clashing with my hair.
Yeah, you didn't think that one. This is the hair dye era, isn't it? This is where you guys discovered... I don't know. Did you use yourself, or did you get... This is professional.
We had somebody that used to do that.
Believe it or not, this was a professional job.
Hotel bathrooms and just splurged it all on.
Yeah.
This is Son of Dork era too here. This is kind of where the hair started,
right? The beginning of the hair. Well, the Brit Awards was the beginning of the hair.
Yeah. Right.
I've gone for a slightly kind of parakeet look.
You do look slightly parakeet.
Do you know what?
If a parakeet was a goth.
The problem with this haircut, and this is the thing, when I first got that hair, I was like, it was different, it was new, it was like, I felt like we'd done something really cool, and it wasn't as extreme in the beginning. It got more extreme as it went on, and it sort of became more like this complete two-tone thing. But about, like, it was in Son of Dork, it was like, Busted was long gone, it's like 2005, and I remember being in Southend, and there was a table of mums having Sunday brunch,
oh, no.
And they all had my hair. And I James, thought, James time was to the, change it up.
James it's was time, the first ever Karen.
I had a Karen hairstyle.
You invented the Karen. I think you need a round of applause for inventing the Karen. I mean,
Karen Bourne.
I mean, James invented the Karen.
It was so bad. I mean, I just kind of was like, I have to change. How has no one told me?
Aww.
I
mean, so should we go with Pretty Fine or Pretty of the Time?
Pretty of the Time.
I'd say Pretty of the Time.
Okay, great. And you know what? I think we'll leave it on that. No, I don't think it can get better than James inventing the Karen. I don't think that's where we leave it. Thank you, lads.
Fantastic. Thank you.